We'll start with the revision for lesson one. In lesson one, we highlighted the meaning of technical writing, the main objective of, or the general objective of the course, according to the title, is how to make you write and present technical documents. So general objective of the course is at the end of the course, the student should be able to develop competence in presenting academic and technical information in written and oral form to a variety of audience. So this is the objective of your course, of this course, Technical English. You have to be able to write and present documents, technical documents. Okay. Specific objectives of lesson one. At the end of the course, the student should be able to use appropriate expressions and structures in academic context, produce grammatically correct sentences, identify and apply effective writing techniques, apply the rules in writing technical documents, and give effective oral presentations of written work. to show the meaning or to define technical writing, we presented these two definitions of time. This is the definition for time, the first one, and this is the second definition of time. So please read both of them and tell me the differences. In both of them, the writer is trying to define time. Okay, done reading? Over. So this is the first definition of time. Someone to read? Okay, would you please read it aloud?
Time is a right for me from more, for which everything and everyone move forward to it their
fate. So time is a river flowing from nowhere through which everything and everyone move forward to meet their fate. This is one way of writing. The second way of writing is this one. Yeah, so please, someone here to read? Someone to read? Adel,
read. Time is a contingent of measurement based on the microwave spectra line emitted by cesium atoms with an atomic weight of 133. And an integral frequency of
So this is also a definition of time. What's the difference between this definition and the second one? Can you tell me the differences between them? It's so simple. Yes.
The second one. Is especially.
Is there any use of images here?
No.
Feelings?
No.
Emotions?
No.
Imagination? No.
Just
facts? Scientific? He used quantity, like measurements, hertz, numbers, numerals, yes? So this form of writing is called technical. Okay, and the first one is called literal. Do you know the meaning of literal? The one we use in writing or in presenting novels, stories, poetry, poems. Okay, so this is how you have to write as technical writers. You have to be to the point, factual, scientific, this thing. We say that we have to express and not impress. Your duty is not to impress the reader. is not to touch his feelings. Your duty is to to express, to convey information, to convey details. Okay? So, characteristic of technical writing. These are the most important characteristics. First of all, technical writing covers broad fields. It's not only, it's not like only IT students will use technical writing. Also, people working in medicine, in education, yes, even in,
in many
fields. It depends on your goal, your intention, your, yes, and many other things like your audience, and we know about the meaning, why we have to consider audience. You have to be accurate, precise. Precise means try to write as less as possible. Yeah, to the point. To the point. Logically organized. Why logically organized?
Sticking for that.
Logically organized, so not to confuse the readers or your audience. So not to hear. Okay. Here, it's okay. Mechanically and grammatically correct. This is also one point you have to keep in mind. Your writing should be grammatically correct, because if it is full of mistakes, what will happen?
Wrong meaning.
Okay, this is, it will affect accuracy, one thing, and then readers, what will they think about you and your institution, your organization? They won't think that you are professional enough, isn't it? It will give a bad image. Yes? This will cause other people to think that you are not that professional.
That's
if you are
clear.
Writing or you are, for example, I don't know if I have it here. No, today also I forgot to bring them with me. You know those manuals? Manuals?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. If you buy a video player, if you buy a laptop or whatever, you will find the manual. It there you will find, how to use it. You will know about the parts of the laptop and so on. Then if you find mistakes, you will doubt the quality of
this.
First of all, you won't be able to understand how to operate, and then you might also doubt the organization or whatever, the company. Then audience analysis. Audience analysis. Who are the audience? Audience? Do you know the meaning of audience here? Audience? By the way, keep in mind that you have to come to this class with your dictionary. A soft copy one, one in your mobile, or a hard copy. Because it's not my duty to translate things for you. And this also will help you understand words better. So please come with your dictionaries. You can have them also on your mobile, so it's really easy. Before you start writing any technical document, it is important that you know your audience. So what's the meaning of audience? Speak aloud, huh?
People.
Okay, say it in Arabic. Give me the translation. Oh, yeah. Could you hear her?
No.
People. Your readers. Your readers here. Your, what they call it, also customers and clients and those people. Technical writers adjust. You know the meaning of adjust? Modify, change. So technical writers, you as technical writers, sometime or you have to adjust your writing to meet the needs, interest, and background of the readers or audience. You have to do this because we have four kinds of audience in general. What are the four kinds of audience? These are the four kinds of audience. We have the technical audience, and those people will easily understand what you're talking about because they are technical like you. But there are also the semi-technical audience. They work in technical fields, but their field is different, what they know is less than Yours. Yes. The other field, technical audience, they're from different fields. But still, they need to know something about your research. And then the non-technical audience, they're laymen, the common people. Okay? So you have to meet the needs and expectations and background of those audience. I will go to lesson one. Is this lesson one? No. where?
Number two. Yes.
Okay. Here, there is an explanation. For audience. See, these are different visuals used in technical writing. In technical writing, you will make use of visuals like pie chart, maps. See, this is
a table,
yeah, and so or images, photos.
Interfaces.
Yes, sometimes, yeah, they are called visuals. So, here, this is the word, visuals. So, in technical writing, you will also add some visuals, but keep in mind that those visuals, however, they require interpretation or explanation. You need to explain them, those visuals. In the text of the report, especially when the audience may not be familiar with them. Now, audience, these are types of technical documents. You have correspondence, like notes and memos, letters, and forms of electronic mails. You have also sales, marketing, and promotional material intended for readers, customers, or for sales representatives who work with customers. You have directions and manuals. Directions, like how to use it. Yes? Yeah, instructions. Reports also, that you sometimes you have to prepare reports for your head manager or proposals. Mm-hmm. This is one form. This is a format for a memo. Yes, is this a memo? Yes, I believe it's a
single.
Yes, medical and how it is presented. This is one of the formats, or this is also a title page. How to organize your details in a title page, the cover of your book. You have the title of the book. And then prepared by or prepared for the company. You have the name here. And then prepared by your name. Okay, so and then here, yeah, you add the date and month. And this is a table of contents, how to organize contents, with what to start, what follows, and so on. Audience, we say that we have four kinds of audience. The technical audience. What do you have to answer? Your technical audience looks for answers to questions like, what result did you get? How did you check your data? Yes. The semi-technical audience. This includes others who are trained in your field and know about current trends. However, these people, such as co-workers, who have different duties, colleagues at the other companies, or teachers or students, neither do exactly the same work, nor are responsible for its completion. They don't do the same work, yes? And they're not responsible for its completion. And they're more concerned with where did you get your data, and what was your procedure, method. The other field, technical audience, they're from different fields. So those people will know less about your field. So you have to be clearer here. Yes? It's not like talking to professionals, the semi-technical and technical audience. Those people know less about the field. So the language you use must be clearer and less complicated. So they are your department head, especially leaders and workers in other departments, research, production, sales, in your company, and their counterpart in other companies. However, Your other field technical audience expects answers to questions like, how can we improve our product? How much will it cost? And how long will it take to make changes in production? So this is their concern. Your writing should focus on these aspects. Finally, the non-technical audience is the general public. They are those who are interested in your field or in your work or both, but are not directly involved in either. Your non-technical audience is interested in answers to questions like, what research are you doing that will benefit the consumer? What harmful effects might your work have on people's health?
The
yes?
The difference between not professional and other fields.
Other fields
have, we can say, simple information about technical.
The other field technical audience, they're not from the same field, they're from other fields,
but still,
they know about technical, yeah.
They're
interested, yeah, in technical documents because they also do some technical work. But other people, non-technical audience, they're non-technical at all. And I asked you to do this, write a one-sentence definition of a term in your field for two different audiences. One will be graduate students in a totally unrelated field, while the other consists of fellow students in your own graduate program. Here, define any two terms in your field, but one of them, keep in mind that the audience or the reader is a graduate student who knows nothing about your field, and the second one will be for a fellow. A fellow means one of your classmates. Yes, he knows about your field. This was the assignment I gave that day. And then we moved to the second one, and where we highlighted grammar. Some topics in grammar which you need. One of the problems faced by students is the subject-verb agreement. Yes?
Yes.
And there, I will go back to the revision. Okay. Here, before we start discussing the subject-verb agreement, we have to know how to indicate number in nouns and in verbs in English. See, two different ways. In nouns, to indicate singularity, we don't add S or ES, minus S or ES, but for plural, we add S and ES, like book, books. This is a book, these are books. Singular plus S or ES, just the opposite, see? So to indicate singularity in verbs, we add the S and the ES. Here, writes. The boy or he writes studies. The boy is singular.
Yes.
The verb is also singular because I added S.
Yes, because it's singular.
Yes. And plurality, no addition of S or ES. So I hope this is clear and you have to keep it in mind because sometimes you have the knowledge but you don't practice the rules in your writing. So try to avoid this mistake, and now I clarified the doubt here. Then we talked about subject-verb agreement. We say that verb agrees with the subject in English. This agreement is clearly indicated only, okay, here, only, gosh, only where? Yes, when the noun is in the third person singular. So in English, this number issue is clearly, or is clear, in the third person singular, only. See, here I is singular also, but do I say I write?
No.
No. When I say she, then I S, yeah, I use the number marker. So what I mean here is that to indicate plurality, I mean number, we have first person and we have second person and